It's in a neighborhood you've likely never been to, 18th and Vine in Kansas City, Missouri. And yet the story it tells is about who we are and where we've been, as a country, as an economy, as a people. It's the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum.
This is a new history for virtually everyone who encounters this story. You know, they don't know about the Negro Leagues because it's not in the history books.
The Negro Leagues. For roughly 40 years, 1920 to 1960, black ball players playing on black teams in front of largely black fans, a lot of them. One year, the league drew 400,000. But it was a raw time in American history. Segregation wasn't just tolerated, it was trumpeted.
Really, there was never any doubt about the ability of these athletes to play. People knew. It was the social conditions of our times and fear that kept these guys out of the major league.
It is Bob Kendrick's job to get the story of the Negro Leagues out, get it told, and to keep the museum as a business economically viable. Museums in general, African American institutions in particular, are not having an easy go. The Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, an exception, rising attendance every year since it opened on this spot 10 years ago.
This was once a very prominent, thriving African-American community. But like a lot of urban areas in this country, it had died. And the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, when we anchored here, it was our desire to help resurrect historic 18th and Vine.
And it's starting to work, a once blighted neighborhood coming back to life. Families and young professionals moving in. Clubs and the Jazz Museum have opened along with the NLBM, and corporations, the Bank of America, is partnering here.
Oh, I think absolutely made good business sense.
And good business sense is something that has a long tradition in the Negro Leagues. Owners and players both made very good money, and an entire black economy built up around the teams. Hotels, restaurants, barber shops, every conceivable business necessary to service the players and fans who couldn't get service anywhere else was started up and thrived.
Cities across this United States that had thriving black economies, they also had thriving black baseball in those cities. Black baseball led black businesses really to their economic heights.
And then 60 years ago this year, Jackie Robinson saw the Brooklyn Dodgers breaking the color barrier in baseball. It was a triumph and the beginning of the end.
What was good morally, what was good socially, was absolutely devastating economically for black businesses. And so, you know, it's interesting that there's always a cost for progress.
In a way, the Negro Leagues continue to make business deals, not only with the B of A, which is supporting this year a nationwide NLBM tour to black colleges and universities, but with sportswear manufacturers, retro jerseys, and hats. It makes for a better business, reaching a new audience, and it makes for a better place.
You can see the remarkable change in landscape here.